हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज समीरन मैथी, सीनियर लेक्चरर इन कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक। इफ यू रिमेंबर, वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद ACN, दैट इज फिफ्थ सेमेस्टर सब्जेक्ट फॉर CO एंड IF ब्रांच। एंड द फर्स्ट चैप्टर विल कंप्राइज ऑफ टू वीडियोज। आई हैव ऑलरेडी अपलोडेड द फर्स्ट वीडियो, काइंडली वॉच दैट वीडियो एंड देन कम टू इट। इफ यू रिमेंबर, द फर्स्ट वीडियो एंडेड विद NAT, सो द नेक्स्ट पार्ट After NAT, we have IPv4 header format. In case, if they are asking IPv4 header format, you are supposed to draw this diagram. Now, this diagram consists of first block as version. So, this is V4. So, the version will be 4 and the byte allocated is 4 bits. Then we have header length. Header length consists of source address, destination address and the byte allocated for it is 4 bits. Type of service is nothing but whether the packet will be using connection oriented service or connectionless service. That point should be added in type of service. And total length, we have 16 bits. Identification, for that we have 16 bits. If you remember, the packets are sent in the form of fragments, so that fragments must be particularly identified. For example, this is fragment 1, this is fragment 2, this is fragment 3, and so on. Then we have flags. For flags, we have, you can see this diagram, for flags it is a 3-bit field. The first bit indicates whether more fragments are there or not. Second bit indicates don't fragment it, no sort of fragmentation is further required, and the last bit is reserved. And finally, then we have fragment offset. Now, what is the purpose of fragment offset? At the receiver side, all the division of packets, all the fragments should be reassembled. So that is the purpose of fragment offset, and the bit allocated for it is 13 bits. TTL is 8 bits. Now what is TTL? For example, if TTL has become 0, that means the validity of that packet has been exhausted. Now the packet has to be discarded and it is to be sent once again. Protocol, the packet can be sent for TCP protocol or UDP protocol, so that is the purpose of protocol. Then we have header checksum. As the name implies, it is used for error detection and correction. Then source address, bit allocated for it is 32 bit, which contains sender's address, destination address contains receiver address, and last point is options and padding. For example, if there is a requirement that packet has to be sent in the multiples of 32, but my packet has only 27 bits, so how to make it multiples of 32? We are supposed to left pad 5 zeros to it. If we left pad 5 zeros to it, so it was initially 27, now plus 5, so 27 plus 5 becomes 32. Now the packet is ready to be sent. After IPv4 header format, we have ICMPv4. So in case if they are asking this question, you are supposed to write, it stands for Internet Control Message Protocol. It is a protocol that handles error and other control messages, and it itself is a network layer protocol. You are also supposed to draw this diagram. It is starting with the last row, that is frame header. Frame data, trailer is optional, and in frame data we have IP header and IP data, and in IP data it consists of ICMP messages. So ICMP messages are of two types, error reporting messages and query messages. As the name implies, the first type of message will be used for error reporting and the second type of message will be used for query purpose. The main functions associated with ICMP are, it handles error, it tests readability, it controls congestion. In the sense, if sender is sending too many packets that the receiver is not able to handle, then congestion control has to be done, that is being served by ICMP. Route change verification, in the sense, if the packet has to be sent to from a particular route, but that particular route has now traffic in it, so route has to be changed, so verification for the same has to be done by ICMP. It measures performance, it divides addresses, that is subnet addressing, and it has some type field. The meaning of the same is there in the next slide. This is the type field of ICMP messages. Remember students, all the type fields are not important. If you remember only 4 to 5 type fields, then it is sufficient. So type field 0, we have echo type message. Type field 3, we have destination unreceivable message, and so on. ICMP message meanings, echo request for that code is 8 and echo reply for that code is 0. This pair of query messages is used to diagnose problems in the network. Both of these messages determine whether two hosts can communicate with each other or not. So for example, if echo request message is sent and echo reply message is coming from the receiver side, then they could communicate with each other and so on. Destination unreachable, as the name implies, the packet has forgot the destination address and hence the packet has to be discarded and the packet has to be sent once again. Sequence message is used when host sent too many packets that the receiver is unable to handle. Time exceeded, in the sense when TTL has become zero, now the packet has to be discarded and the packet has to be sent once again. Timestamp request and timestamp reply, this time it takes to travel a host from one host to another host, is detected by the timestamp request and timestamp reply messages. Parameter problem message is used by ICMP if the header field is invalid. Now, message format of ICMP message, in case if they are asking, you are supposed to draw this diagram. It consists of type, which for which 8 bits is allocated, which determines or identifies the type of a message. For code, the size is again 8 bits. It provides information about the type of a message. And for checksum, we have 16 bits. It detects the error in ICMP messages. An IP header and original datagram, this field can be used for diagnostic purposes by matching with the information in ICMP message with original data in IP packet. Coming to debugging tools, firstly we have ping, that is packet internet groper, which is an internet utility used to determine whether a particular IP address is reachable online by sending out a packet and waiting for a response. Ping is used to test and debug a network as well as see if a user or server is online. Now, in your command prompt, type ping space your IP address, for example, ping 192.168.1.5. So it will tell the particular IP address is alive or not and how much time the packet is taking to send and receive. The particular information will be gathered. To get a better insight, you go to your command prompt, type ping space 192.168.1.5 or any of your IP address and you get a better idea how ping works. Next is trace route program. It is available in Unix as well as Windows and it can be used to trace route of a packet from source to destination. The trace route command is used to discover the routes that packet actually takes when traveling to the destination. For example, type tracert space google.com in command prompt. Then obviously the sent packet won't go directly to the server of google.com. Instead, it will take hops, probably 3-4 hops, and then it will go to google.com. It will also show the IP addresses of the various hops used to go to google.com. So again, to get a better insight into it, go to command prompt and type tracert space google.com and you'll get a better idea how tracert works. Coming to mobile IP, in case if they are asking mobile IP, you are supposed to draw this diagram. Try to concentrate how mobile IP works. If my laptop is connected to my home router, then I am on a home network and I am using a particular IP address. But for example, I am traveling and my connection of laptop should not be lost since some important work is going on. That is, the connection should be active even if I am out of my router's range. This is done by mobile IP, where I have the same IP address of my home router even if I am at the range of some other foreign router. I hope the point is clear. In case of any doubts, you could post a comment and I can surely help you with it. Now, components of mobile IP. Mobile node. In our above description, the laptop that was moving from home network to foreign network was mobile node. Home agent is a router of home network. Foreign agent is a router of foreign network. Correspondent node is to maintain permanent IP address. Coordination is required between home agent and foreign agent. That coordination is managed by correspondent node. I hope the points are clear. Whenever you come across components of mobile IP, in case it is nodes, then those are mobiles, laptops, cell phones that is connected to a network. And in case if you are coming across agents, those are networking devices like router. So home agent will be home router, foreign agent will be foreign router. I hope the points are clear. So now, how mobile IP works. So it has three phases. Firstly, we have agent discovery. For example, if I am sitting at a park with my Wi-Fi on in my mobile, then I get a list of Wi-Fi that is on surrounding the park. Fine. How does I get it? By agent discovery, those Wi-Fi, that is routers, that is agent advertises themselves to make sure that our mobiles are within their network. That was all about agent discovery. So whenever mobile node is at home network, home agent will advertise, and when the same mobile node goes to foreign node, then foreign agent will advertise itself. I hope the point is clear. Coming to registration, if mobile node has went from home network to foreign network, then obviously mobile node should be registered to foreign agent or router, because mobile was initially only registered to home agent, but now since it has come to a new zone or foreign zone, it has to be registered. Once the registration is done, now the mobile has come to a new location, which is known as care of address. Now coming to tunneling. For example, if a packet has come to a home network, but the device is absent at the home network, that is my mobile or laptop is absent at the home network, and if a packet has come to my home network and instead it is at foreign network, the packet has come to a home network's address, but my device is at foreign network, so now tunneling task is done. How it does? So to send the packet from home network to foreign network, a tunnel is created to send the packet from home agent to foreign agent. This is the purpose of tunneling. I hope the point is clear. In case of any doubts, you could ask me or post a comment. The features of mobile node are: it is transparent, it is compatible, it is efficient, it is scalable. Coming to the last topic of the first chapter of ACN, virtual private network, it is based on IPsec protocol, in the sense internet protocol with security, that is the packets are in encrypted form, hence it is secured. It is based on tunneling strategy, in the sense it is protected from outside world, and this tunnel is imaginary, no real tunnel is used. It uses authentication, that is proof of identities like ID, password is used. It also uses encryption, that is message is hidden for security purpose. Now, what is the need of VPN? Low cost and remote places. Low cost and remote places, if such are the parameters, then VPN must be used. And it uses internet, as you can see in the diagram. So the actual communication is taking from client to local network of client to public network to again local network at server side. As you can see the black line, I'll repeat, it uses internet, as you can see in the diagram. So the actual communication is taking from client to local network of client to public network to again local network of server and to its server, that is the black line. But due to the security and tunneling, it appears as if the connection is directly from client to server. You can see the red line. So due to appearance of direct communication between client and server, its name is virtual private network. Virtual means unreal. In reality, direct communication is not happening, but is appearing. Hence, virtual private network. And why private? Due to security, since public network is unsecured and private network is secured. I hope you have got the idea how VPN works. These are some of the advantages and disadvantages of VPN. This was the last slide of the first chapter. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye.